I can't hold this marriage together all by myself. You've got to do your part.
I do my part. I decorated this whole house.
I'm not talking about decorating a house. Anybody can decorate a house.
Oh, is that so?
I'm talking about understanding and being patient and putting up with a few things.
Well, I put up with plenty.
Susan, that's just not the point. You've got to do it without recriminations and feeling so all out sorry for yourself.
Oh, is that what you think? That I'm just feeling sorry for myself?
I know that's what you're feeling, and you've got to stop it or this marriage is going to fall apart. Every word I said. And while you're thinking about it, I think it would be very wise of you to stay away from that liquor cabinet.
Thank you. That's the story of my mother's life. Always intrigued by what she can't have.
Well, it's only a phone call. If it's really important, they'll call back.
Everybody. Missy, is it you?
Oh, Missy, what is it? What's wrong?
Oh, I can't! I'm
tell me what it is.
Mother, it's Bill. Mother.
What's that, Bill?
Mother, there's been an accident.
What kind of an accident?
Mother. He was out sailing on his boat. Yes? Go on. He was out sailing, Mother, and there was a storm. Came up, Mother, and the boat capsized, Mother. Mother, it turned over. Mother, I don't know.
What happened?
No, God, Mother, Bill, Mother, Bill's gone. Mother, Bill's dead.
Return to our story in just a moment.
Susan and Fred?
Yes, they're coming.
Well, you didn't tell them what happened?
No, she told me not to.
No.
You know.
Yeah, I'll get it. Come
in. Something wrong with Liz?
We came as soon as we could.
Yeah, something very wrong, I'm afraid.
Oh. What is it, Liz?
Oh, Jim. What's happened? Sit down, both of you. Bill is dead. Sailboat. He was alone this time. Lots of times he takes Moose and Ricky with him, but this time he was alone. A storm came up very suddenly. A terrible storm. His boat turned over.
Liz, drink this, please.
No, I don't want any brandy.
I think she needs a doctor, Wayne.
Yeah, good idea.
Do you want me to?
No, that's all right. I'll phone from upstairs.
Where's he going?
He'll be right back, dearie.
Well, it seems the mast of the boat, the mast hit Bill on the head while he was in the water. There was another boat nearby, and the people on saw the whole thing. That they say knocked Bill unconscious. They tried to help him. They tried to get a line to him, but they couldn't get near enough. It was a terrible storm. They saw Bill's body washed out to sea.
Liz.
I couldn't even find his body, Melissa.
There's no chance, no possibility that he...
No chance that he could have survived. No chance at all.
Look, dear. Is there anything that you can think of that we can do for you right now?
I don't know exactly.
What about Melissa?
Somebody should be with Melissa at this time.
Yes. Of course, somebody ought to be with Melissa. I suppose I ought to fly out there.
Do you think you could do that?
She can't marry. We'll go.
Would you like us to do that?
Oh, Mary, can you?
Of course we can do it.
Melissa's so very fond of you. You way back when she and Bill were having all that trouble, you were so kind to her.
Nonsense. I love Melissa.
We'll go.
So good of you, Jim.
Not at all. Melissa should have a man with her. Somebody around at a time like this.
Yes, you're so kind.
Oh, darling.
Grandmother, do you remember?
You know how children are very, very shy. Even an old folk like me knows that.
Yes,
sir. Here, buddy boy, give me a hug. Give your mother a hug.
Myself for a change. What fun.
Well, I hope you enjoy yourself. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to finish getting ready.
So, of course, we want to look our best, don't we? Want to make a good impression. After all, those clients from Hobart are very important people, aren't they?
Thank you.
Can I fix you a drink?
Oh, not yet, thank you. I think I'll wait until the others get here.
Oh. All right. Here's to Bay City and Somerset. Long may they both wave.
Well, I'll drink to that. As long as I may add, may Sam Lucas wave along with them in Somerset.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi, darling.
Ah, here's one of our missing ladies. Little old sweetheart.
Hi. Wonderful.
You used your own baby's savings for this ridiculous extravagance?
It is not ridiculous, Russ. It's an absolutely beautiful apartment. Besides which, I didn't take out all that much money. You see, because in the meantime, your Aunt Liz and Mr. Drew, they both gave me checks to put in the baby's trust fund, and I used those.
Don't you realize that's even worse?
Worse?
Not only did you take money from the baby's trust fund, but you used gifts from parents and friends, relatives and friends, for a purpose for which they were not intended. Rachel, you've done some pretty wild things since I've been married to you. But this, how could you do it?
Do what, Ross? Honestly, I swear to you that I just don't know what you're talking about. The only reason that I didn't tell you about the apartment is I wanted to surprise you. And anyway, so what if I took the money out of Jamie's trust fund? I mean, the apartment's for him. I did it because I wanted him to live in a nice place.
You're a liar. I said you're a liar. You didn't do it for Jamie, you did it for yourself. You moved in here because for some childish, idiotic reason you had to live here. And it's the most disgusting thing I've ever heard of.
I want you to be nice to her.
I'll be nice to her. What do you think I am?
She doesn't know where you are yet. But when I tell her, I think she's going to come running. And I want you to help her. You hear me? Now that kid is mixed up. She isn't always nice. Anyway, what I want from you is that you come through for her, you hear me? She thinks you're some kind of a god.
I'll help her all I can, if she comes.
She'll come. You just help her, Jerry.
She may not come. Because you may not bring her here, not after you hear what I have to say. Sit down, Ada. I got something to tell you.
Yes, This afternoon on Another World, Lahoma learned from Sam that he has taken the job and they will be moving to Somerset. What lies ahead in Another World, Somerset? Premiering Monday, March the 30th at 4, 3 Central and 2:30 Pacific Time here on NBC.
And if you do decide you want to help me out on this deal, as I'm sure you will, I think you'll know exactly what to do.
I know this is supposed to be a happy occasion, but it's a sad one, too.
Well, I think that's the way it is with most things in life that are really worthwhile. But as for me, I refuse to think of this as the end of anything that we've had together.
Well, of course it's not the end. Come on, look, I'm still going to be working with all of you, even if we do live in Somerset. And, look, I'm going to fix it so that I have to come back a lot.
Well, not without me, you're not.
May all their dark days be behind them. May their future be bright and sunny, and may they be as happy as they deserve to be.
Hear, hear.
Well, you know, Lahoma and I can't drink to that. I mean, we can't drink to ourselves, so... Well, we'll drink to our friends. All of you have, done so much for us. And all of our friends here in Bay City. And we wish that all of you may have all of the happiness that you wish us.